about God and I ask you, what is the first characteristic that pops into your head? Okay, does anybody want to share? You have one.
Peace is kind.
Kind, good.
Loving.
Forgiving. Good. Anything else?
Honest.
Honest. That's good. Now I want to read to you a verse from Romans 11, verse 22 says, behold therefore the goodness and the severity of God. Now which two characters of God do we see in this verse? Let me read it to you again. It says, behold therefore the goodness and severity of God. There's two characteristics here.
Goodness
and severity. These are two. Now maybe you think, how can goodness and severity come together? Now every guy has a word that says God is good all the time.
God is good.
Now I want to tell you that lots of times people get this picture of God, but sadly a lot of time people's image of God is totally out of balance. They either only look at the goodness of God or they only look at the severity of God. Now the first thing I want to tell you today is I've got two cups here. Now the Bible tells us if you have not been born again, you cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. So that is the standard that God has set. So if we have to say that this is the standard for us to enter into heaven, we can almost say this is like the severity of God. Because can God let anything dirty come into heaven?
No.
No. So this is his standard. But because we all know the story of Adam and Eve, and the sin has been passed down to generation, and therefore the Bible tells us we all have been born in sin. So this is our current condition, but this is God's standard for us to enter the kingdom of heaven. Now the severity of God will say nobody can enter the kingdom of heaven unless he looks like this, and there's no grace. Man, that's the severity, this is the standard. But because of God's goodness, he saw the problem, and he gave us a way to